Carrying a pretty heavy load here. Gotta get this plane on the ground somehow. Stairway's locked. One of these goons must have a key.
Shoot him! Get him!
Top deck is locked too. Locked. We'll be right back. Neo-noir's not a good idea right now.
Don't shoot!
It's okay, ladies. I'll get you out of here and back to your families. Whoa, hey, I'm trying to save you.
You a coward? Fight me! Don't shoot! No!
Shot the pilots and took off for the cargo deck. He's probably gonna jump out the hatch and let this bird sink to the seafloor. I knew that he was crazy, but I didn't think that he was.
Do you know where I'm leading you?
Some of that a few hours ago. If a hook gets in the cargo hatch, he could parachute out of here.
Here's to your death, Jackson.
I gotta take out his magic potion.
Ah!
He fell like a silk-suited brick, and probably floated about as well, too. Problem now is finding someone to land the plane, or someone to show me how. Can you land this thing?
Autopilot is locked. Gear isn't responding. You gotta override both switches before I can do anything.
Where?
Two switches. Front and rear avionics. Hurry up!
That's the switch. There's the other.
Ah, that did it! She's responding! Now just hold on to something tight, cause she's going down heavy!
Kip Waterman, and hurry! Waterman, Jack Slate. Yeah, I know you're getting ready to go on the air, that's why I'm calling. Listen, a cargo jet full of extremely interesting cargo is about to hit the ground outside Warden Air Force Base. If I'm not burned alive in the crash, I might have the story of the century for you.
It better be good. Remember, I'm putting my ass on the line.
Here.
What's this?
Your Pulitzer Prize. Only one catch.
Yeah, what's that?
I died in that crash. You got me?
Yeah, sure, whatever. So, what's the story?
You'll understand when you read what's in there. How soon can you get that on the air?
Is 10 o'clock too soon?
10 o'clock is perfect. Now, you think you can drop us off at the Bay Bell? I got one last loose end to tie up. They say it's always darkest before the dawn. It was pitch black by the time I got back to the Bay Bell. I was battered and bruised, but I wasn't quite done yet. The city was now short one mayor, not to mention one mayoral candidate. Hildy was dead and so was Eve. Augie Blatz, Fahook Abdul, my dad, everyone except the one man who really deserved to die. But I still had a few bullets left.
You're a dead man, Slate.
These guys will keep coming until I bring down that attack chopper.
He's mine. I got him sighted.
It's armor plated. I'll need heavy artillery to bring that thing down.
Slate!
Don't have to yell, Dick. I'm the only one here.
I owe you one, Slate. Even I wouldn't have had the balls to kill the mayor. And with both Bahook and Blatz gone, this city is practically mine. And all that gold. You have any idea how much power that can buy me?
Yeah, it'll buy you one hell of a funeral.
Cute. So where's that evidence you stole from my station?
I gave it to a friend for safekeeping.
You did what? Who?
Now how safe would it be if I just told you?
Information has surfaced that implicates key officials in both City Hall and the Grand City Police Department in what federal authorities are already categorizing as capital racketeering and organized criminal intent.
What did you do?
Central amongst those implicated is Lieutenant Dick Hennessy, head of Grant City's anti-crime squad, and the target of many who feel that his strong-arm tactics fell beyond the law.
What did you do?
This fountain can't be too good for that electrified riot shield. Keep running, Dick, and you'll only die tired.
Hotshot, gonna give up like your old man? I hear he practically begged for his life.
Go to hell.
Chilly in here.
Come on.
Let's sit by the fire and I'll tell you the story of how I killed the late, great Slate Boys.
Sizzle, it was over. The truth was in the air and the feds were on the case. Not that there was anyone left to implicate, but I'm sure they'd find their share of scapegoats. And I'd rather not stick around long enough to be one of them. With Hennessy, Blatz, and Fahook all dead, the inevitable struggle for power would begin. It would take an atom bomb to rid this city of crime. But I was fresh out of plutonium. I'd had enough. My own bundle of sins were enough to keep me awake for the rest of my life. But I had to believe that bringing the bad guys down would have some karmic benefit down the road somewhere. Somewhere other than here. I didn't mind, though. In fact, I was looking forward to leaving. They say Grant City's the hardest place on Earth. The people aren't born here, they're made. That fortunes are lost and found on a daily basis. And if you're not one of the lucky finders, you're probably dead. Well, I can tell you this for a fact. Jack Slate is about as far from dead as you can imagine.
Partial list of victims from the recent plane crash outside Warden Air Force Base. No survivors were found in the wreckage of the disaster that claimed the lives of 68 passengers. Among the deceased is fugitive Jack Slate, wanted since his daring prison escape moments before his scheduled execution. Doctors say the remainder of his corpse was burnt beyond recognition and consider themselves fortunate to have established conclusive evidence to close the statewide manhunt.
Faith, Padre. Faith.
God bless you, Jack Slate.
God!
I'll see you in hell.
I'll see you in hell.
See you in hell.
See you in hell.
Both of you in hell.
See you in hell.
I suppose I'll see you in hell.
See you in hell.
In hell. See you in hell, Junior.
I can't believe you beat me, Jack Slate. Here are your cigarettes.